Richard, I blame you for this. This is like a good idea.
I have nothing but good ideas, right?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I wasn't aware of that part.
Well, good is in air quotes, I think.
We've done this a million times on the carbureted single plane versus dual plane, which is kind of the same thing. It's a runner length test.
That's the age old test.
Right. This manifold is going to be pretty tricked away. We can change the actual runner.
Yeah, it's really cool. They got like inter, so we can just put it in and change the runner length.
You invented this, right?
Yeah. Shh, don't tell anybody that.
Okay. So now we're just going to run this thing for a baseline. You got the long runners
in
it right
now. We have the long runners in it, which is kind of like, that's a fast manifold. And this is what it would be if you just bought a fast manifold. It's got the long runner in it.
Oh, is that how
they come? The nice thing about this, though, is it's adjustable, so we can put the small in later on.
Okay. So we got nothing now but to run it and get a baseline. You've already got it warmed up, tuned up, ready to go?
Let's go. Let's make it happen.
Okay. Pretty stout for low compression motor, even at 408.
I know.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, people should just put LSs in everything.
Man, that could be a new thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wonder if we could influence that. Okay, so the power that we're making with our naturally aspirated 408 with the long runners installed, 549.3 horsepower at 6,200 RPM, and we're making 526.7 pound-feet of torque at 5,100. But look, the curve is kind of struggly here. It's not like as nice and pretty and smooth as I would expect.
You can see how that falls over. That's the runner length.
Is that the runner length?
Yeah, and especially on a 408, this manifold obviously was designed for a 6 liter and kind of below, so on a 408, we start to see that.
Is this what you were seeing when you were baselining
the
thing?
It,
everything's happy, copacetic,
okay. 549, that's the number.
Easy enough.
That's our baseline.
Next step, go in there and put short runners on it and make more power up here.
There we go, that's what we hope, right?
Okay.
Let's go.
These guys have all the gas drained out of this thing. Our process here is gonna be pull the fuel rails off and then lift the whole lid off of this thing. But what's really entertaining right now is Richard blowing in that fuel hose.
It's from my siphoning days.
Fucking loose.
There we go. Yeah, ultra sexy.
All right, now we need the torques.
Prise off like so.
Hold it down. There we go.
Just got a man up, I guess.
From the front to the back.
Look at that.
Got a man up.
That's actually a really cool intake manifold. So what is the actual difference between the runner length that we're seeing here?
Three times.
Yeah, that's quite a bit. Wow. So you can see, this is the part that goes up against the cylinder head, and this is the mouth of the port. And you'll notice they're actually bell mouthed more nicely on these red ones because there's room to do that. By the bell mouth, I mean that curve right here, the radius entry all the way around, which, by the way, is way better for airflow than just a sharp edge. Makes a significant difference.
This is like a child's toy. Do they have a Star Wars one of these?
We got the short runners installed. Here comes the lid.
Here we go.
Hit this front guy, there we go. Gotcha.
Uno más.
Fuel rails. Mm-hmm. Get it on the injectorators.
Short runners.
Yeah, short runners.
Yeah.
What do you think's going to happen?
I think it's going to make less bottom end torque. It's going to carry the RPM a little bit more.
That's kind of the theory, right?
See, we don't even need the dyno.
If you could just draw me a curve really quick, and we'd be all done, right?
I think we do need the dyno because the dyno is going to tell the story.
Only the dyno knows for sure.
And you know because you've already run it. That's right.
Well, I'm clairvoyant.
Yeah, but don't spill the beans. We want to see it hot off the dyno.
Good?
Oh, I'm ready.
All right, let's go.